If you're reading this, I must be dead. I can't reach over, take your hand, or tell you not to cry. That's the hardest thing of all about not being with you anymore. But it would be silly to ask you not to miss me. What if you didn't miss me? No. No chance of that. You're missing me now, reading this, aren't you? Plan to haunt you, Stu. So beware. Did that make you smile? Hey, what if I can do it? Watch for the signs.
Breakfast! Here it is. Come and get it.
Coming.
Goodbye letter you wrote me 5 years ago is in my old lecture notes.
I forgot about that one. I tore the other ones up.
The others?
I wrote one to each of the children, too, just before I had the operation. Come on, seems like 100 years ago. Let's go.
5 years, exactly. Wait a minute. Let's celebrate the 5 years.
Breakfast is ready.
So am I.
Mom! Coming!
Whose idea was to have kids? Yours?
Brad, come on, I haven't read that yet.
Oh, please, but I need this for school. Oh, please, just this little bit. I gotta go. Thanks.
You like mustard?
It's okay.
Lettuce.
It's
lettuce.
Okay.
Well, look at me.
This shirt is too big, it's too red. I look like a tomato.
You look terrific.
Bye, Mom.
What about lunch?
I'll buy lunch.
Do you have money?
My clothes.
Now, wait a minute, young lady. Reconceptualize the problem. Think about what you do have instead of what you don't have, okay? Because if you...
Why don't you go in and get my white leather belt, pouchy sweater over the belt, and put on my red shoes, okay?
Thanks, Mom.
That's what I was gonna say.
Mm. Oh, Lord, it's late. Go.
Go? Hey, wait a minute here. What about our celebration? You have an appointment with your psychology professor, Moira.
I do.
You want an A in human sexuality, don't you?
Reschedule me.
Do what?
Okay, watch the corner. Okay, bring it in, leave it in the middle. Moira, where do you want this?
That's okay, just leave those here. Ben, Sally, would you take this painting and put it right there on the opposite wall? Oh, it looks good. Yeah. That's right. That's right. Oh, it's sensual, don't you think?
Different.
All right, bring those two and put them right next to it, please. That's good.
Or I don't see it. You say tomato, I say tomato. It's a forest fire. We're sensual.
How did I get an adding machine for a partner?
It's a good thing you did, or we'll balance the books.
Oh, that's good. Just put that right there.
Oh, Moira, take a look at Max Berry. He's a new artist. He's going to sell very well. We should give him a show. Over here, Ben! These are rocks. Ceramic rocks.
Ceramic rocks.
Sensual, wouldn't you say?
You say tomato.
Sensual doesn't pay the light bill.
Gaining insight into your divorce.
That's mean, Moira Lamovich. I'm gonna tell your husband that you cheated on his mid-semester quiz sophomore year. Brownie Cares Gallery.
I didn't cheat. I happened to glance your way, that is all.
One moment. Glancing counts. Here, sell something.
Oh, this is Moira Browning. Can I help you?
Right.
It's Mike. Can you spare me an hour this afternoon? I'm firing my nurse.
You want me to fill in? I faint at the sight of an aorta.
I'm firing her because she was supposed to run a couple of more tests on you the other day, and she didn't.
The x-rays were clear, weren't they?
Well, I'm going to charge you for the test, whether I run them or not. My office at 1.
I'm leading a therapy group at 1, Mike. It's my first time. I can't back out.
Come at 3.
Mike, this is a crazy day. We're changing exhibits. Couldn't I come in tomorrow?
You want me to work on Saturday?
How about next week? Friday.
Today, 3:00. Goodbye.
I don't know how to file these. Who was it?
School. A conference with Brad's teacher. 3:00.
Under C for Caldwell or under T for total loss? We have a meeting with that bozo from the Arts Council at 3:00.
You'll have to manage without me. Sorry.
I'll cancel. Let him put his hand on somebody else's knee.
Get it while you can.
Oh, I hate you smug, happily married types.
I'll have you know I'm dating a lawyer this week. He makes Redford look like yesterday's fish filet.
Something wrong, Moira?
No.
Every time I meet a man, I think, should I tell him the truth or lie?
Show him your x-rays. That always turns them on. Well, if a guy can't deal with it, I say to hell with him and the horse he rode in on.
Yeah, you said it.
Stu and I fought it together. It wasn't always easy.
But you're already married. That's different.
Cancer breaks up a lot of marriages.
Yeah. I hate it when men feel sorry for me.
Marva, what do you say to that? Maybe they hate it, too. The trick is not to let them.
It's all done with mirrors, right?
You know there's more to you than your cancer. Let the men you meet know that, too.
You did great. Just go with your instincts. You've got them all in the right places. And don't be afraid to go after a non-talker. If things get a little too quiet, try repeating a phrase someone has used. Moira?
What?
I'm sorry. Here, I want you to look over these files. And try and get Andrea Parrish to speak out a little more. She has a baby and an 80-year-old father living at home with her.
I'm not sure I should be doing this.
Cold feet.
I'm a patient. You're a qualified professional.
Ex-patient. And who's better qualified? Moira, you can help these women. You've been there. They know that. Where's the fire, if you don't mind my asking?
Gotta get back to the gallery. See you Monday. Thanks. What you should really measure is the length of my nose. I told 2 lies about where I was coming this afternoon. I don't even know why, they just popped out. Maybe I'm superstitious. You know, like if you don't tell your wish, it comes true. Only in this case, of course, it's the other way around. If I didn't tell, then it wouldn't come true. Kids do things like that. Brad, he's my youngest. He always wears a certain pair of socks when he takes a test. If I haven't done the laundry, he takes them out of the hamper. Are you superstitious, Pat?
I'm a nurse. You can go ahead and get dressed. The doctor will be in to see you in just a minute.
not ready, Mike.
I want to get a second opinion.
Find out I'm ugly, too. You know, Mrs. Smith, you're dying. I'd like a second opinion.
Okay.
You're ugly, too. It's come back, hasn't it?
I want to start you on radiation therapy immediately.
You said if I was clean for 5 years.
There are no guarantees, Moira.
Stu and I celebrated last night.
You want me to tell him?
No.
Okay, anyone not through the exam is gonna have to take a course in efficient cheating. Okay, the war is over. Go on home and live in peace.
If you stick your legs out anymore, he's gonna trip over them.
I play his lectures back every night before I go to sleep.
Like a tranquilizer?
Like an aphrodisiac. I'd love to do an independent study with him.
He doesn't give independence.
You can talk him into one, Meg. Didn't you do an independent last term with Halverson?
He wasn't such a hot shot. Profane in class, sacred in bed. He never took that damn pipe out of his mouth.
Browning's married.
All the more reason why he would appreciate a nice, firm body.
You're right.
I'll put in a good word for you tonight when he comes home for dinner.
Nice going, hot shot.
I ran into a couple of cheerleaders in the bathroom.
Sorry I missed the classes, Phil.
They were fighting over your body. The brunette was the best looking. I said I'd put in a good word. Of course, I'd appreciate it if you'd wait a decent interval.
Carry my books, maybe I can find an opening.
Everyone without cancer, take 2 steps forward. Not so fast, Moira Lamovich. Lousy little spot.
But I thought that...
So did I.
What are you doing so far away from me?
I don't know. Come and get me, won't you? I don't want to go home.
I'm not taking you home.
Better a bang than a whimper.
What?
Nothing. Where are we going?
I don't know. Come on.
Rush. Got all the time in the world.
First stage is denial, not anger.
Skipping the first stage. It's my second time around. I'll go in any order I want. All right. Let's find some restaurant where we can eat and make love. Must be some place around here like that. It's a college town.
How about the Cat's Cradle Motel?
You think it's still there?
I don't know. Let's go find out.
It's 30 miles!
We didn't mind that drive 20 years ago. You just keep your hand off my knee until we get there, huh?
With a very annoyed lawyer.
I have been humbled in the eyes of your son because I cannot make part 204 stick to part 206. And I just hope you were out doing something vital to national security. Thank you for coming over. You didn't have to stay, you know. Janie is 16.
Ah, Janie, yeah, she called in 5 minutes ago. She said not to wait up.
Oh, get out of here, you two. I saw that little exchange. I know where you've been. I can see it in your eyes. I hate you both. Well, good luck. The instructions are in Braille. Good night. God bless.
Oh, I'll walk you out to your car.
Oh,
big boy. Let's walk around. Yeah. Oh, there you
go. He's not coming back, Maura.
Yeah.
Your date last night. Honey, I've got cancer again. Mommy wants you to be mommy for a while. Mommy. The girl is 16. I've got cancer again. I'm sick again. I have cancer again.
Is it true? You got it back?
Danny, half the women at the center get recurrences. It's no big deal. I just hated to tell you, that's all.
I was going to call a family council, you know, like last time. Break the news, hand out brownies. I'm not going to die. Half the women at the center get recurrences.
You said that.
As I remember, you were a terrific cheering section. Every morning there was a knock-knock joke scotch taped to the mirror.
Stop it. No games this time.
Janie, look at me.
When's the operation?
There's no operation.
I start radiation therapy Monday. What else?
You can ask me anything.
Greg's family invited me to spend the first week of summer vacation at the Cape. Can I go?
I meant questions about the cancer.
Can I go?
Well, we were planning a trip to New York, the whole family. I thought we'd see some plays.
I'll have to discuss it with your father.
Years, I hope.
If nothing works?
No, no. If nothing works, that's not the...
If nothing works.
If the cancer's particularly aggressive, there's always a chance we might not be able to halt it.
You told her that?
She asked for the worst. You know Moira.
Yeah, I know Moira.
Hey, nice serve. Out.
Free court. How about it?
Brad's lesson's almost over. I want to get back to the house.
Stu? She beat it once.
What's this then, round two?
The only other sound's the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. The woods are lovely, dark and deep. But I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. and miles to go before I sleep.
Promises. Anybody? Andrea.
I want my husband to remarry.
Don't worry, honey, he will.
He needs someone. We have a baby. My father lives with us now. Jack, my husband. He has terrible taste in women.
I'd like to pick out Ted's next wife. She'd have to be over 40 and no better looking than me.
You're putting that in the personals.
Yeah, but what about references? You're not hiring a cook.
A cook, a nurse, a bookkeeper? Hey, it'll take an army to fill my shoes. Yeah. Oh. All
right. I just want her to love Jack and the baby.
What's going on around here? Nobody's done anything for me to yell at them about all week. I want you to shape up and start acting lousy.
Are you crazy?
Crazy? That's how you talk to your father? Get up there and wash your mouth out with soap right now. Now, go on. Discipline. I feel much better. Hey, where's your sister?
Careful. My husband will be home any minute.
Good guy.
And insanely jealous. Mm. He hates to have my salad tossed by another man. Okay. Now, are your hands clean?
By the hospital, you'd left.
I changed my appointment.
Why don't you tell me?
Radiation therapy doesn't require two people.
Well, neither does sex. It's so much more fun that way. What time tomorrow?
There's no reason for you to rearrange your schedule.
But I want to.
I'm the one with cancer, not you.
I'm the coach.
Jenny voted no games this time. I second the motion.
Where is Jenny?
I don't know. Probably with Greg.
She coming home for dinner?
I don't know.
Well, I'll phone her. Where is she?
I don't know.
You're her mother. She's a kid. It's dinner time. Where is she? And what's she doing with this guy? Is there something you do know?
You're her father. You ask her. She doesn't fall under my jurisdiction just because we're both female. You talk to her about Greg. You write the textbooks. You have the answers. You talk to her about birth control.
Birth control? How did we get into birth control?
You've got to be there for her. If you're not there for her, who is?
What are we fighting about?
We're not fighting.
Time out. That's why I married you. I start the fights and you apologize. Now look, you're gonna have to talk to Jenny. You are gonna talk to Jenny, not me, not anybody else. You're gonna be here for her, for Brad, for me. You're not dying. You don't shut me out. Do you hear me? Knock twice. For yes, one for no. Ouch. You're not leaving me.
Thank you.
What's the matter, honey?
Wasn't in the picture. I wasn't in the picture.
Okay, it's all right. Come on, back to sleep.
Quality, you know, a unique sensuality. I think it's reminiscent of early Van Gogh. Moira Bowdy, my partner. Come over here and get in this picture. Ted's going to make us famous.
Hello, Moira.
I stand in front of my favorite.
What's the name of the picture?
Untitled number 14.
Thank you.
This wine tastes like cleaning fluid.
Well, what do you want for $2 a bottle?
$2?
You can thank me later. Thank you.
Listen, you got $2.
Oh, I think it's so wonderful. It makes such a statement, like the kind of art we have in Arizona. It's just as tasteful and lovely.
Who's the tootsie circling your husband?
I don't know. You want I should break it up? I'm good at that. I'll just go put a cheese knife in her back, Cynthia.
Wait, give it.
You're even fun. Did I tell you? Jim is going to remarry.
You know you didn't.
Thought I'd save it for a dull moment. A stewardess. Don't look like that. I couldn't give a rat's derriere. She's an airhead. A prepubescent airhead. He has custody in the summers, you know. My kids are going to spend weekends and 3 months a year with an airhead. Should probably teach them to vote ultra-conservative.
Do they like her?
Of course they like her. They like Madonna. They like Smurfs. Come on, let's circulate. Count your blessings. Why didn't I marry my psychology professor?
I got him first.
First is right. I put my phone number on the final exam.
You did?
Yeah.
So did I. Well, you should have answered the phone.
What?
We were roommates, you don't. We had the same number. I can tell him you're still available.
Why weren't you so generous 20 years ago?
Did you like the exhibit? That's what Cynthia said. You do have the same taste.
In art, maybe, not in wine. What was that swill we were swilling anyway? Lighter fluid?
Her ex is getting remarried.
Well, he's entitled.
Cynthia should remarry. I can't understand why she hasn't. She's smart. She's pretty. She has a terrific sense of humor, don't you think?
Don't I think what?
That Cynthia is attractive. You never told me she put her phone number on the final exam.
But I asked for you, didn't I?
Cynthia and I were roommates. We had the same number.
Well, I figured I'd date whichever girl answered the phone. My wife. 20 years, she's jealous. I think I'll keep her. Cynthia answered the phone and I asked for you, maniac. Don't you remember?
If I'd said no, would you have asked her out?
Probably. But you had the good sense to say yes. And they lived happily ever after. What is it, Myra?
It's all right. I just feel funny. Maybe you're not supposed to mix radiation and $2 wine.
Thank you.
me give you a hand.
Don't you think I can handle it?
I didn't say that.
I told Brad it was routine, that the treatment I'm getting is insurance.
And Janny?
She knows. She hopes it won't interfere with her vacation plans.
Is that what she said?
Her boyfriend's family invited her to the Cape.
Here, go to the left.
Well, I hope you said she could go.
Well, you tell her you have cancer and she asks if she can take a trip. Hello, anyone home?
Did you expect her to ask you outright, hey, Mom, are you dying?
I thought we'd been so close.
I'm such an idiot.
You're not an idiot. And I wish you'd come back to the group.
No.
Moira, it helps to talk. You know it does.
The cancerous leading the cancerous. I remember when I first started coming here right after the operation. Most of the women were like me, post-op, scared. But there were a few who were recurrences, women whose cancer had come back. Oh. I used to sit as far away from them as possible. Isn't that awful?
And now?
Don't start anything you can't finish.
What was that?
Kids are coming home from school. Do I feel thinner to you?
A little. You haven't been eating much lately.
One of the things I'm afraid of is how you'll start to see me. I'm thinner. Lie to me, okay?
Moira, you're gorgeous. I really don't see any change at all.
Was that a lie?
No.
Was that?
Moira, you're thin as a rake. You're so thin you could stand in for a knitting needle. You want to talk thin? Well, now I'm talking thin here, folks. You are so thin that you have to run around in the shower to get wet. You are so thin. You are so...
I invited Cynthia to spend next weekend out here.
What?
She's a little down.
About what?
Jim getting remarried, for one thing. And don't mention the lawyer. She broke up with him.
Why?
He wore legal briefs in bed.
Oh, very funny. You're a joker, Cynthia.
Stu. Well, be extra nice to her.
Your wife says I'm supposed to be extra nice to you.
Bottle of sunblock and put some on Stu's arms before he burns.
Can he put it on his own arms?
Put some on his nose, too.
What is this?
Red snapper.
That's not what I mean. You know what I mean. Moira, what's going on here? Last night, you sent Stu out for ice cream. Now, the man has lived here for 20 years, but you decide he can't find his way to the corner store. Cynthia, go with him. You want a company.
I didn't feel like it.
No, wait. Am I being paranoid? You go upstairs to take a shower, leaving me with a dish of honey vanilla and your husband. But before you go, you put on Johnny Mathis, whom I loathe, by the way, and dim the lights, muttering something about an electric bill.
You don't loathe Johnny Mathis. You adore Johnny Mathis. Chances are it's your theme song. I hear you humming it while you balance the books. Anyway, you played both sides of the album. Did you and Stu dance?
Is with you. Come on, out with it. That stupid remark I made about putting my number on the final?
If I'd been busy, he would have asked you out. He said so. He's always liked you. And you like him.
You rub his arms. He's your husband.
Where are you going?
Home. Whatever games you're playing, I don't like them.
I'm not playing games.
Oh, well, then what is this? A test? Our friendship, loyalty, his? You're sick.
You find Stuart attractive, don't you?
You want to know if I find your husband attractive? You want to know if I'm going to jump into bed with him the minute your back is turned?
I want to know that he isn't going to marry some prepubescent airhead who will turn my kids into ultra-conservatives.
Moira, Stu is married to you. The cancer's come back. Would you marry him, Cynthia? Crazy. A woman is not a light bulb. Screw one out, screw one in. And you're not dying.
What if I am?
What if I get hit by a seltzer truck on the corner of 5th and Tremaine? Stop saying it. Stop thinking it. Moira, I'm fond of Stu, but it stops there.
You gave me your phone number.
20 years ago. Good Lord, I don't want to marry him. No offense, but, I don't want to go to bed with him. I'd go to bed with him. But it would definitely be a one-night stand. You, didn't tell him about this little matchmaking scheme, did you?
No.
And you won't swear on the life of your children. Couldn't look him in the eye again if I thought he knew. Swear
on the life of my children. You should be flattered. You were my first choice.
It was your second? No, I am not having this conversation. Whatever made you think of this?
It was a girl in group. She was worried about her baby. She wanted to help her husband find a good wife and a mother. And what you said about Jim's new bride, the prepubescent stewardess, I don't know. It makes sense to me. It's no different than writing a will, putting your affairs in order. I don't like to think of Stu on his own.
Would you stop putting nails in your coffin? You're spoiling my lunch. Cancer can be cured. I've seen it on General Hospital.
Well, then, General Hospital.
I feel like an idiot.
You tell me that it's come back. I want to say something to you. Something besides I'm sorry. And all the time I'm just thinking, thank God it's not me.
Excuse me, is that chocolate cheesecake?
Oh, yes.
Oh, it looks so wonderful. Wish I could afford those calories. How do you eat so much and stay so thin?
Cancer. It eats up cellulite. It's absolutely amazing.
Didn't know the world would fall apart without me, did you?
Are you okay?
Come on, let's do it together. Come on. That's right. That's very good.
Oh, you're very good at this.
Look. We're doing it. See.
You know, I really do.
I have some good news for you, Moira. The treatment is starting to work.
It's in remission?
Not yet, but we have the cancer under control. You're responding very well.
But it's not in remission.
I'm very optimistic. Watch my lips, Moira. The treatment is working. I'm very pleased. What's the matter?
I don't know. Why should good news scare me?
You were expecting a death sentence, weren't you?
Don't you guess?
Because you asked me to drive you. Why not Stuart?
I am shutting him out. I just don't want his life to become a death watch.
I know how you feel. You want to take charge of everything. Keith had a list. Things to do before dying.
Keith?
My late husband.
I never knew you were married.
Well, therapists are supposed to listen, not talk. Besides, it was a long time ago.
She's back.
I thought you said she'd be at the gallery. He's your father.
Well, look under the bed.
It's beautiful. I didn't realize you were right by the river. I always like being near water.
So does Stu. He's never forgiven his fishy ancestors for crawling onto the sand and growing lungs. Come on in. I think I'm going to cook this salmon on my breast with a little feta cheese.
Oh,
that
sounds wonderful.
Very delicious.
No. Wait, what?
Oh, why aren't you at the gallery?
Oh. Hello, Mother.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello, Greg. Remember Suzanne James?
Hi, Jenny.
This is Greg, friend of Jenny's. Would you put some water on for tea? Be right back.
could you?
I didn't do anything.
That is my bed.
I said I didn't do anything.
Nobody makes love in that bed except your father and me.
It's none of your business what I do.
I am your mother.
You know what that makes me? Next in line. What do you want me to do? Wait around for my first lousy x-ray? You know what your odds are if your mother has cancer? I'm gonna get it, you know, just like you. And if I'm stupid enough to have a daughter, what do you think her odds are gonna be? If I even live long enough to get married, if anybody even wants to marry me.
Johnny.
Don't touch me.
I never hit her. Go see if she's all right.
She needs you.
I'm the last thing she needs.
Please.
She's speaking to me. Barely.
Every parent's entitled to an act of senseless violence every 16 years, provided the rack isn't involved.
I had no reason to hit her.
She had no reason to play kissy face in our bed either. Maybe you were both looking for a fight.
Do you remember when I first got cancer? She was Brad's age. She used to tape knock-knock jokes all over the house to make me laugh.
She's scared.
So am I.
Treatment's working. Cancer's not spreading, Moira.
I can't think about it, okay?
Now listen to me. I said we'd beat this thing, and we will. Just don't shut me out.
It'd be nice if you sprayed the
fur. All right, the meter's running. Here, you come on, get out of here. Everything's gonna be all right, Miss Skyla. Don't you worry
about it.
Back
door. Yes, don't forget to lock it. I always check
I will
before
see
I go to sleep.
Tomorrow, go to the auction with Cynthia. Have a good time.
We have an hour before the auction. What's your pleasure?
You remember Donovan?
Donovan?
Mellow yellow. Quite right.
Oh, Donovan.
The night we went to hear him sing, I had my hair down to here.
You want to go back to incense and love beads?
Yeah.
It's idiotic, isn't it? To be dying and still vain.
You're not dying. Your doctor wouldn't lie to you.
He goes by tests.
You go by tea leaves?
I feel it. Everything I do, everything that happens, it's like little pieces, and I just can't tie them together. I have nightmares, awful ones.
We all have nightmares.
You don't think I'm going to make it
don't
either.
Don't you tell me what I think.
Oh.
We come here every year for an auction, and every year we get an inside room with a view of the laundry. This year we've got a very expensive view of the city. Moira's last auction.
Off-season rates, Camille. You think you're so smart, don't you? Want to dance?
Baby, you
want to
see dancing, honey?
Yeah, rock and roll.
You want to see it?
Oh, do it to me.
Oh,
move it, baby.
Yellow
like her.
Quite right.
Nah, don't want you to get excited. Brad's been sick.
No,
nothing serious. Just a little stuff. Because I didn't want you running back here. There's hardly any fever at all. Moira!
You're back.
Where have you been?
At the diner with Greg.
Say the word and I'll rent out your room.
I had to get something to eat.
There was chicken.
Ask Dad about the chicken.
To a crisp?
Yeah. How's Brad?
His fever's down. When did he get sick?
Yesterday. Dad took him to the dentist with 101. Hygiene has had a fit.
Poor Stu. Jenny, I wish you'd spend a little more time around here.
Why?
Remember last summer when you were teaching Brad to dive? He's so pleased when you pay attention to him. Maybe you could take him to the movies some night.
With me and Greg?
On a night when you weren't seeing Greg.
Brad and I don't like the same movies.
And then something else. You know, bowling. Miniature golf. Put your hand on his head.
What?
So you know what a fever feels like.
I'm tired. I'm going to bed.
Good night, Jenny.
Night.
You all look so gorgeous. I wish I had the camera.
Oh, the camera. Did you bring the camera?
I didn't bring the camera. Did you bring it?
Well, I asked you if I should bring the camera, and you told me not to.
I'm sorry. What are we going to do?
Why don't you ask the waiter?
Waiter!
No,
he looks like he carries
no
a camera.
It's my birthday. I should have a picture of my birthday.
Ah, your birthday. Don't expect any presents this birthday. Right, gang?
Absolutely.
And nothing this year.
One lobster dinner, and that's it.
I've been such a good girl.
These are hard times, you know.
Do you know what a lobster costs in a place like this?
You just behave yourself. This is a classy joint. No spilling.
And don't ask for ketchup.
No slurping the soup. Keep your elbows off the table.
Don't embarrass us, okay? Don't scream or anything.
Why would I scream?
Oh! Oh! Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to Mom.
Happy
birthday to you.
I'm going to change your treatment.
It's not working?
No, it's not working. There's evidence that it's present on the lung. No, I don't want you to become discouraged. I've had some very good results with chemotherapy. Here's a prescription. These are gonna help you with the side effects.
When it's time to stop all this, tell me. Promise.
Moira.
If I'm gonna die anyway, I don't see why I should be bald and nauseous in the bargain.
No, I think you'll find that with chemotherapy much...
Promise me. Or I'll tell everybody you cry at dog pounds.
You wouldn't.
Can you afford to take that chance? Michael?
I promise.
When you were little, I had cancer and I had to go to the hospital. Cancer's come back.
Do you have to have another operation?
No.
That's good.
that Dr. Mike was giving me medicine, and that was helping for a while. Now they're trying something new that's supposed to be even better. Cancer comes back lots of times. Lots of times it goes away again.
Does Johnny know? Are you telling me the truth about this new stuff?
I'm telling you just what the doctor told me.
You look good.
I know it. I know it.
Come and sit.
Why are we meeting here? What happened to this fabulous macrobiotic whatchamacallit lunch you were gonna make?
This will have to do. You'll like it. I don't have a stove. I don't even have an apartment. They're rewiring the electrical system in my building. Apparently, it violates every safety code known to Thomas Edison. We had to move out this morning.
That's awful.
It won't bite you.
What exactly is it?
It's good for you.
Healthy, huh?
Mm-hmm. So, doesn't it feel good sharing lunch with a homeless person?
I wish you'd asked me before you offered.
It's only for a week. She was planning to sleep at the clinic.
Hasn't she heard of a motel?
She didn't want to come. I insisted.
Why?
You've met Susanna a half a dozen times, and you've decided you don't like her. You hardly know her.
She's a therapist, isn't she? Now, let me guess. She's got two bumper stickers. The one in the back says, have you hugged your kid today? The one in the front, I break for psychos.
Are all psychologists as prejudiced as you are? Get me a pillow.
6 to 1, she comes in here with a t-shirt that reads, today is the first day of the rest of your life.
That one's in the wash, actually.
The door was open. I knocked.
Okay, glue.
Glue?
Okay, right there. No, no, where my thumb is. That's it. Not too much. Stop. Okay. Now hold these two pieces together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And whatever you do, don't let go, okay? I shall return.
Can't I help?
You're helping. Usually I've got the propeller in one hand, the paprika in the other. Did you ever want kids?
Very much. Keith and I talked about it there. Just wasn't enough time. I envy you, Brad and Janny, one of each. That was always my ideal family. What are you making?
Chicken cacciatore. You could still have one.
One what?
Ideal family.
I recognize that voice. That's the Suzanne I know a terrific fella for you voice. You better not have invited some man over for dinner. I swear I'll tell him I'm gay.
Are you?
No fix-ups, Moira. I appreciate the thought, and no, I'm not. What are you putting in there now?
What are you afraid of?
Never analyze an analyst.
Sorry. Oregano. The secret of a good cacciatore. Stu likes a lot of it. He likes it practically green.
How about if I make a matching dessert?
What is going on out there?
Must be a food fight. Huh?
Frightens me the most. Don't cry. Oh, let me hear now. It's all right.
No, that's all right.
Laura still sleeping?
Yeah, she had a rough night.
You wish you could have the pain for her?
Oh, please, no dime store analysis before breakfast.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I wasn't trying to analyze. I was just, remembering. My husband died of cancer.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know that. Don't pay any attention to me. I haven't had my coffee yet.
Oh, please.
No, thanks. How'd you get through it?
3 yards at a time.
Yeah, it sounds easy.
No. But it looks good embroidered on a t-shirt.
Okay, I'm sorry about that remark yesterday. I didn't know you were standing behind me, obviously.
You're entitled to your opinion.
Well, I think I'll go for a walk. If Myra comes down, tell her I'll be back in about an hour. What the hell are those?
My landlord doesn't allow pets.
Ah.
Yes. Yes, quite sweet. Yeah, Jake. Forget it here.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Like the prince in Cinderella, putting on the glass slipper.
Hey, Carter, feet probably smell. Here.
I invited her to stay because she needed a place. That's the funny thing. I never even thought of her as a candidate.
As a candidate? You're not so... I thought you gave up on that insanity. You're so hot to be a matchmaker. Would you get me an introduction to Prince Rainier?
Stu and Suzanne have a lot in common now that I think of it. Her husband had cancer.
Good. That's a real conversation starter. You're not going to pull it off, Lamovich.
You don't reach out from the grave and manage people's lives.
I'm not in my grave yet.
That's the most intelligent thing you've said so far. Moira, you're alive. If you think Stu is making eyes at Miss James, show her the flip side of the welcome mat.
She's right for him, and the kids like her. She's always wanted a family. I want him to make eyes at her.
Do you? Do you really?
I thought I did. Oh, what I want. I'm tired. Go home. What's the medication? I'm all right. Do me a favor. Call Stuart. Tell him I've gone into the city and I won't be home till after dinner. Tell him it was business.
What business? I'm a lousy liar. Moira!
To go away for a few days by myself.
What about Suzanne? Doesn't that seem just a little rude taking off while she's still here?
Her being here is what made me think of it. Kids like her. She'd be a big help to you. I wouldn't feel so guilty about leaving.
Well, that doesn't seem very fair to Suzanne. She's not here to play house mother, you know.
She might want to once you explain the fringe benefits.
Look, if you want to go away for a few days, it's okay. I understand.
I'll leave tomorrow.
Have you seen my reading glasses?
Maybe you left them in the study.
All right, what's the matter?
Nothing. Go find your glasses. Go on. Go up to your study. I'm sure Suzanne is still awake. I'll be asleep soon. Why don't you take her for a stroll by the water? It's cold at night, so don't forget a blanket.
What are you talking about?
Go. I want you to. I want it to happen. I want you to fall in love and get married and be happy. She's always wanted a family.
Are you crazy?
Have you kissed her yet? Have you?
Okay. I kissed her. Today, between classes, I took her down to the clinic and made love to her on a stretcher. Why shouldn't I? You and I, we're not married, are we? We don't have two kids? And I don't love you? How am I doing? Is that everything? I don't love you, you don't love me?
I do love you. Try to understand.
I understand. Someone to cook my meals. Warm my feet at night, raise the kids. Raise our kids. Hell, if you die, I'm gonna go right down to that city and bring back a lady mud wrestler to raise our kids.
Stop it.
No, you stop it. This is all about how you see it. I don't even exist anymore. You don't know me. You have no idea who I am. What are you trying to make easy, my life, your death? Maybe I don't want it to be easy. Do you ever think what I want? I'm the one who's been betrayed here. I'm the one who's got to live without you.
Moira? Moira, I want to talk. Moira, please wake up. Moira?
I heard you talking. I couldn't answer. Damn pills.
I got Suzanne a room at the motel. It's okay, she understands. You can still go away if you want. I'd rather you stay, though. It's not because I miss you. I just like the way our toothbrushes look lying next to each other in the sink. What happened last night? I...
You're bleeding, Hotshot.
What the hell?
It's all right. I'll do that. Here. I'm such an idiot.
No, I'm the idiot. The professional idiot. I'm supposed to know better.
Nobody's perfect.
I must have known what this was all about. I don't know. Maybe something in me was in cahoots with something in you. Here. Keep your feet warm. You're a very lucky lady.
I know.
Moira?
It's all right. You don't have to say anything. I knew it all along. Don't ask me how. In a way, it's a kind of a relief. Now maybe the dreams will stop.
Would you like me to drive you home?
I'm all right, honestly. Did Stu tell you about last week? I tried to find him a new wife. I had a really good one picked out, and then I blew it in a jealous frenzy. Did you ever hear of anything so idiotic? My friend Cynthia keeps giving me articles about curing cancer with apricot pits and wheatgrass. Did you ever taste wheatgrass? Oh, speaking of Cynthia, we're showing a new artist at the gallery. Some wonderful lithographs you'd really love. Oh, Michael. How do I tell them?
Moira Lamovich, prom queen. Or whatever happened to baby Jane.
You didn't tell me this was a costume ball.
The management wishes to apologize for the distinct odor of mothballs. Dance with me, Stu.
Been into the cooking, Sherry, Mrs. Brownie?
No, just into the attic trunk. I was looking for my swimming medals. I wanted to give them to Janie. I was state champion, you know. Home song. Michael called you. I'm sorry.
Come on, hum. Hum.
Chasing us apart, and you couldn't find me.
No matter where you were, I would find you. It's all right. Oh, baby, it was only a dream. Because I'd find you no matter what. I would look and look, and I'd never stop until I had you back. I want you to remember that. I want you to remember that. It's very important. It's very important because the medicine I've been taking hasn't worked. I meant what I said. I am always going to be with you because I love you both so very much that I could never, ever leave you because you're so sweet. But I won't be here. And you won't be there. And it's gonna be hard. Especially at first. So you'll have to carry me inside. You're gonna have to remember how much I love you right this minute. Even when I can't come into your room and hold you like I am now, you'll still have that love inside. And we won't be in different places.
When is it permissible to pass on the right?
And the man on your left is 90 years old and going 2 miles an hour in a 30-mile zone. Sorry I'm late. Oh, Jenny, what are you drinking?
Iced tea. Do you want some?
Yes, please.
Okay.
I thought you already had your driver's license.
No, I take the written test next week.
How's she doing?
4 out of 5 so far.
You're the brains of this organization. Do you like this?
Very much.
So do I. What do you think that means?
Either I'm getting commercial or you're developing taste.
You know, I never thought I'd live to see the day.
I almost didn't.
Cut out my tongue, okay?
Mom! I can't find my yellow shirt. Did you look in the dryer? It's not there.
I'm coming. Hold your horses.
Thanks, Danny.
Come on!
too.
She took him to the movies last night.
No.
Godzilla versus Mothra.
One of my all-time faves.
It's gonna be all right. I know it's gonna be all right. I just wish.
What?
Brad's 11. One day he wants to be a pilot, next day a tennis champion. Janny hasn't thought any further than college. I wish I knew how it would all turn out.
Maybe you will.
Life after death. A little cloud with a peephole for looking down at the living.
Maybe there's reincarnation. Maybe you'll come back as a trapeze artist.
Or a spider.
Oh, don't say that. I always killed them.
You better stop. Hi.
Hi. How you feeling?
I just meant to fall asleep for an hour. What time is it?
A little past nine. Why don't you take your clothes off?
Come lie by me. I want to be close to you. Stuart Brown. Thank you for having such a nice last name. So much better than Lamovich.
Just a roll of the dice in Ellis Island. If love could save someone, I would have saved you.
I know.
I keep wondering where you'll be after you die. Are you going to be comfortable? Are you going to be cold? Crazy, stupid thoughts.
Not so crazy. Not so stupid.
You too.
No atheists in sick beds.
I wish I could play God.
I wish we could make love.
We are.
The worst part about dying is that I won't be able to talk to you anymore. That I'll be in a place that you're not. 17 years. 2 children I'm damn proud of. A PhD, an art gallery, and oh, oh yes, glorious love. I've tried to think of what I should say to our children.
Never worry about other people's opinions. Be proud of yourselves. The salad fork is the one on the outside. Always peel fruit in a foreign country. Imagine that. A husband and wife who were lovers for 17 years. Not shabby, Stu. You said, if love could have saved me, but it has. We did a good job. Growing that love stuff in the Browning home. Share it with someone else, will you?
If someone else can get your love, then a part of me continues. No, don't ask why. It just does. I don't know if I've done this with the utmost of dignity. But maybe dying with dignity isn't all it was cracked up to be. I mean, where is the dignity in leaving so much love behind? I'm not frightened anymore. I'm not afraid to sleep finally.